A shade of uneasiness came into Hawkins's face. He said, "Why, Nancy, you can't believe what you are saying."
"Believe it, indeed! I know it, Si, and I know that we haven't a cent in the world, and we've sent $10,000 a begging."
"Nancy, you frighten me. Now, could that man, is it possible that I— Hanged if I don't believe I missed a chance. Don't grieve, Nancy, don't grieve. I'll go right after him. I'll take what a fool I am. I'll take anything he'll give."
The next instant he left the house on a run, but the man was no longer in the town. Nobody knew where he belonged or whither he had gone. Hawkins came slowly back, watching wistfully but hopelessly for the stranger, and lowering his price steadily with his sinking heart. And when his foot finally pressed his own threshold, the value he held the entire Tennessee property at was $500. 200 down, and the rest in 3 equal annual payments, without interest. There was a sad gathering at the Hawkins fireside the next night. All the children were present but Clay. Mr. Hawkins said, "Washington, we seem to be hopelessly fallen, hopelessly involved. I am ready to give up. I do not know where to turn. I never have been down so low before. I never have seen things so dismal. There are many mouths to feed. Clay is at work. We must lose you also for a little while, my boy. But it will not be long. The Tennessee land—" He stopped, and was conscious of a blush. There was silence for a moment, and then Washington, now a lank, dreamy-eyed stripling between 22 and 23 years of age, said,
"If Colonel Sellers would come for me, I would go and stay with him a while, till the Tennessee land is sold. He has often wanted me to come, ever since he moved to Hawkeye."
"I'm afraid he can't well come for you, Washington. From what I can hear, not from him, of course, but from others, he is not far from as bad off as we are, and his family is as large, too. He might find something for you to do, maybe, but you'd better try to get to him yourself, Washington. It's only 30 miles."
"But how can I, Father? There's no stage or anything."
"And if there were, stages require money. A stage goes from Swansea 5 miles from here, but it would be cheaper to walk."
"Father, they must know you there, and no doubt they would credit you in a moment for a little stage ride like that. Couldn't you write and ask them?"
"Couldn't you, Washington, seeing it's you that wants the ride? And what do you think you'll do, Washington, when you get to Hawkeye? Finish your invention for making window glass opaque?"
"No, sir. I have given that up. I almost knew I could do it, but it was so tedious and troublesome I quit it."
"I was afraid of it, my boy. Then I suppose you'll finish your plan of coloring hen's eggs by feeding a peculiar diet to the hen?"
"No, sir. I believe I have found out the stuff that will do it, but it kills the hen. So I have dropped that for the present, though I can take it up again some day when I learn how to manage the mixture better."
"Well, what have you got on hand, anything?"
"Yes, sir, 3 or 4 things. I think they are all good and can all be done, but they are tiresome, and besides, they require money. But as soon as the land is sold—"
"Emily, were you about to say something?" said Hawkins.